We've all sat in front of the TV and played along with the contestants on Jeopardy and feel really smart when we get a few of the answers correct. Our next guest, well, is very familiar with that feeling as the highest winning Jeopardy contestant ever. He's now on the other side of the podium as the host of Jeopardy and right now the host of the Jeopardy Masters Tournament. Here to talk all about it, please welcome back to the show, Ken Jennings. Yeah. Yeah.
Hey Ken, we're happy to have you back. So you're currently hosting the Jeopardy Masters Tournament. How is the tournament paying tribute to our, who we considered a friend, Alex Trebek?
Alex was the greatest at the Jeopardy hosting job there could ever be or there ever will be. We brought back six of the best contestants of recent years, at least two of whom actually played with Alex, and they're gonna go head to head. You're gonna see all six of them playing every night on ABC. So you'll see rivalries and relationships develop between them. And one winner is going to receive a $500,000 prize and the first ever Alex Trebek trophy, our Aww. Jeopardy Masters.
That's so cool to get the first one. Now, this is a little different because the audience knows where the Double Jeopardy clues are on the board during the Masters tournament. Talk to us about why the change.
This is the one thing we've tweaked for Masters. We're trying something out where before every round, we show the viewers at home something the players don't know, where the daily doubles are. The idea is that we noticed in the studio, there was a lot of suspense when we knew where the daily doubles were, but the players were having a hard time finding them. They'd come close, they'd move away. It was almost like a suspense movie or a horror movie. And so now we show the audience, and if they want to take a look, they can enjoy the suspense along with.
Okay, Ken, I have to ask, because I have this theory, there's a slight pause that right before the daily double is shown, like I can always hear, like I'll say, daily double. Is that, is it just me?
He's laughing.
No, that's because that's something Alex would do. He would often say, answer, pew-pew, pew-pew, and then the daily double would pop
yeah.
up. So if you ever heard the host say, answer, you'd be pretty sure that the daily double was about to pop up.
And nice, Bobby. Like,
good job.
Erica. Yes, Erica. Okay, so James Holzhauer is, of course, competing in the tournament, and he calls himself the quote-unquote game show villain, and even roasted you on Twitter. He also asked why you're, quote, ducking a rematch in last night's episode. So do you two have a rivalry as the top two highest winning Jeopardy contestants? Give us the tea.
Well, James and I went head-to-head in the greatest of all time tournament in 2020. And, you know, good job, James. He finished second place. He's maybe not as happy about that as I was. And he's trying to lure me back onto the game. But let me tell you, hosting Jeopardy may be a tough gig, but there's a lot more job security for the host than for the contestants. I'm a little too old to be playing the young bucks like James Holzhauer. I'm happy to be out.
What is the correct answer for 200? I liked it. Okay, so one of our producers, Ken, is a Jeopardy mega fan, and she thinks she's figured out the five topics you need to know to have a chance at winning Jeopardy. We want you to decide if she's right, okay? First up, Greek, Egyptian gods and mythology, American history, government, literature, my least favorite, bodies of water, and 80s TV movies and music.
Ooh, I like that one.
How do we feel, and how do you do that? How do you feel, are those good?
I didn't know we were so into the 80s. That's great for Gen Xers like me. I think that's actually a pretty good list. When people ask me, you know, how to study up for the show, the things that are always on Jeopardy are actually what you've got there. You know, Greek gods are a great one. Literature like Shakespeare, you should know those. I feel like world capitals and presidents.
Totally.
Your American government. That's probably the most bang for your buck there. Know your world capitals and your presidents.
Okay, that's good. Bodies of water is the worst one, though. I just say the
it's
Nile.
Just so
every
many.
I don't know.
So
I don't know.
Many.
Lots of them. Yep. Oh.
Ken, I got to know, as a host now, you're really coming in your own. I heard you drop that network plug a little bit earlier. So I got to know, how often do you stumble over these questions? Because if I had to read these, we'd be there for, you know, 3 weeks for one game. Like, I don't know all these words. Do you stumble over questions and have to do retakes?
It's really tough because there's 61 clues in every game, and you want to read them perfectly because you want the contestants to have the best shot at responding correctly. And what that means is you take some time to study. Alex used to come in early every morning and look at all the games for an hour or two. I'm not as much of a morning person as Alex, so I come in the night before and I look at the next day's games and I try to rehearse. If I ever do stumble over a word, we can do a quick retake during a commercial. But for the contestants, I like to be as close to perfect as Alex was.
Of course.
Yeah, me too. I have the same philosophy.
And I think, you know, I think he learned something too. I think he learned from Sam that there's so many bodies of water.
Okay.
So you can walk with that.
Wow.
There's so many.
Wow, Ken. Thank you so much for joining us today. DBL Nation, be sure to tune into the Jeopardy Masters Tournament on ABC. Thanks again, Ken. We'll be right back.
What a pleasure. Thanks.